Nick Hujazi, the founder of the Mendez Cartel. Another day on the cut. We're in an old school gym today. We're in Putney. This gym actually is one of the oldest gyms in the country, and it's on the verge of bankruptcy. They're about to go bust because the thing about gyms is the really good, high quality old school gyms don't make that much money. Like, the best gyms don't make that much money. Whereas the commercial gyms, the shitty commercial gyms that bring in loads of customers that aren't that good of gyms actually make loads of money. These old school, high quality gyms that have been around for centuries don't make that much money. So this gym's about to go bust. Donate to this gym, save this gym. Nice. I'll put the link. I'm gonna put the link in the bio of this video to donate to this gym to save it, because it's on the verge of catastrophe, it really is. But this gym's incredible, old school gym, old school vibes. It's shoulder day. Starting off with standing strict military press. We're gonna do the same as we always do. Reverse pyramid, top set, back off set. Start off with a heavy top set and work our way down. I'm gonna move my grip in slightly. I normally have my grip slightly wider on the outer knurling. I'm gonna bring it in to what I used to do, which is a little bit closer. I like to train multiple grips for a while. So I'll do like a wider grip for shoulders for like a year, and then I'll bring it back in. I think if you train multiple different grips when you're doing standing strict military press, there's so many different ways you can work, you can improve the shoulders. There's different, like for me, you're covering your weaknesses. If you go really wide on shoulder presses for a long period of time and you come in closer, which it, for me is a little bit easier and you're more used to it, I think it covers your weaknesses and makes you an overall better presser. So I'm gonna do a top set on 80, maybe two sets on 80, go down to 70, do a couple sets there, then down to 60, a couple sets there. Reverse pyramid, same as always. This is my first set. What's that? You're here. Right, good set. I'll take that. Four reps. That grip does feel a lot stronger than the wider grip. It feels a lot less awkward. But like I said, when you work different grips, you cover your weaknesses. It's like doing close grip bench. People do close grip bench as an accessory for bench, because it makes, when they go back to the normal grip, which is wider, they're a lot stronger. So that's pretty much the thinking here. Bringing my grip in a touch, which is easier for shoulders. I'll do some back off sets. I'll film maybe a couple of my back off sets. All right, third set, back off set, 70 kilo, set three. I did another set on 80, got four again, so this is set three.
Thank you.
8 reps. All right, final set, burnout set. I'm gonna do 60 kilo. This is my 6th set. I did 2 sets on 80, 3 sets on 70. Now my last and final set, set 6, burnout on 60 kilo. Twelve reps, I'll take that. All right, next exercise, I'm doing seated dumbbell press. 3 sets here. I did 6 sets on standing strict military press. I don't need to do much more pressing volume. I'm just gonna do 3 sets here. The dumbbells in this gym are old school, they're different. The old school dumbbells you get in this kind of gym are different. They feel different, they feel heavier. They feel like proper dumbbells. The dumbbells you get in commercial gyms, I reckon, are a little bit underweight. They're not accurate to actually how heavy the weight is. Whereas in these gyms, I think they're a little over. So these dumbbells feel heavier, they feel different, but I can do 3 sets. Let's get it. Tough set. All right, we're on to side delts now. I ended up doing 11 sets of pressing. I did 6 sets on standing strict barbell and I did 5 sets on dumbbells. Only planned to do 3 but ended up doing 5. So I've done a shit ton of pressing volume, 11 sets. Whenever I'm in a new gym or a different gym, I always try and use the machinery available, especially with side delts, because my gym that I normally train at doesn't have a great deal of variety in equipment with side delts. So anytime I get to use a machine side delt, side lateral, I'm gonna use it because my other gym doesn't have that many machines, so I'm gonna use this. It's not the best machine, but it does the trick. A little bit awkward, but I'll do 3 sets here, 10 to 12 reps. All right, we're going to do another side delt movement. We're going to do cable side laterals, but not with a cuff, with a handle. Normally I do them with a cuff because I prefer you don't get any limitations of grip. Handles are still all right, but I haven't, they're not as good as a cuff, but I'm going to do them with a handle because I haven't used a handle in a while. So cable handle side laterals, three sets, again, 12 to 15 reps. Right, last exercise. Gonna finish with some cable rear delt flies, some face pulls. Some face pulls, but on the row, the cable row, instead of the normal cable stack. Normally, when you do face pulls, you do them on a typical cable stack. I'm doing them on the cable row, just a mix up, slight change. Remember, the smallest of details can make the biggest of differences. So, just mixing it up, doing it on the row instead of like the normal cable stack. I'll do probably 5-6 sets here. Kill off the rear delts. Rear delt's probably the most underrated part of the shoulder. And probably the most under-trained part of the shoulder. Rear delts are so important for like a complete physique. A lot of people don't put enough attention, enough emphasis on really working rear delts and working them properly. Some people even start with rear delts because it's that important. And I might start doing that. Instead of starting with a press, I might start with rear delts just to make sure I hit them enough instead of putting them last, because they're that important to an aesthetic physique. But that's the workout, guys. Done and dusted. Another session finished. I'm tired, man. Real tough one today. High volume. We're into week 12 of the cut now, so we're getting there. Another 9 weeks to go. But everything's coming together, getting leaner by the day. That's the workout. Nick Hujazi, the founder of the Mendez Cartel. Guys, I say this every video. Join the Mendez Cartel. We got programs on there, a community. You can ask me any question about nutrition, about training. You can even do live calls with me. We've got a bro split program up there already, and a push pull legs. I'm gonna add more programs as the community grows. Two programs up there that you can use. Community, you can talk to me, live calls, all for only like $5. The price of a can of Coke and a chocolate bar, absolutely nothing. Zero risk. Join the community, join the Mendez Cartel. Whether you're cutting, whether you're bulking, whatever your goals are. That's the workout, guys. subscribe to this channel, follow me on Instagram and TikTok, Nick Ojazi, the founder of the Mendez Cartel. And as always, long live King Charles III, and God bless Sir Winston Churchill.